Hello friends, welcome back to another episode by Engineering Today, and hope you're all having a great time. From booster enhancements to spacecraft preparations, the Starbase facility is buzzing with activity. Let's delve into some of the recent events and what they mean for SpaceX's ambitious endeavors. One of the notable events at Starbase involved the removal and reinstallation of the hot staging ring from Booster 9. The hot staging ring is a critical component in SpaceX's rocket technology, as it plays a crucial role in the separation of the booster and the spacecraft during launch. The removal of this ring is significant, as it suggests that SpaceX is undertaking some additional work inside the vehicle. The decision to remove the hot staging ring allows for better access to the top of the booster. Elon Musk, in his Starship update notes, mentioned that the hot staging ring looks tiny but is hopefully sufficient. This change is indicative of SpaceX's continuous efforts to optimize and refine its rocket design, aiming for improved performance and reliability. Reinstalling the hot staging ring and placing the ship back on top within a day highlights the efficiency and expertise of SpaceX's engineering teams. Another exciting development at the Starbase facility is the activity surrounding Ship 26. It appears that Ship 26 is gearing up for suborbital testing, as evidenced by various observations. The suborbital tank farm was seen spooling up, and the test pad itself was clear, indicating preparations for an upcoming test. Notable events associated with Ship 26 include the sightings of vapors under the spacecraft, the budding frost line on its surface, and a depress vent that was observed. These occurrences suggest that Ship 26 underwent a series of tests, including structural tests and possibly a spin prime test. However, the outcome of these tests remains uncertain, as it's challenging to confirm the success of such tests from external observations. The partial filling of Ship 26's liquid oxygen tank, with liquid nitrogen reaching only two rings, further adds to the intrigue. It hints at ongoing preparations for a significant test or a suborbital flight. SpaceX's transparency in sharing these updates with the public keeps space enthusiasts engaged and excited about the progress being made. Meanwhile, Ship 30 made a brief appearance at the Starbase facility, teasing the observers with a quick glimpse. Such sightings are exciting because they offer a glimpse into the advanced stages of spacecraft development. Although no detailed information was provided in the news pieces, this event serves as a reminder that SpaceX is continually working on multiple spacecraft simultaneously, each with its unique role and purpose. On the other hand, in the realm of space exploration, each mission serves as a stepping stone towards understanding the complexities of the universe. The Starship launch pad anomaly, while not a sought-after occurrence, has unexpectedly provided invaluable insights into engineering lunar landing technology. The research conducted by planetary scientist Dr. Phil Metzger sheds light on this anomaly, prompting NASA to take note and consider the implications for future lunar missions. The crux of Dr. Metzger's investigation revolves around the pressure buildup beneath the Starship launch pad. Astonishingly, the pressure reached levels akin to a volcanic eruption, mirroring the moment when molten magma breaches the cap rock, leading to a cataclysmic expulsion of hot gases and debris. This revelation raises a pivotal question. What can we learn from these launch and landing pad failures to enhance the safety of lunar landings? One striking observation from Dr. Metzger's research is that the ejection velocities of the concrete chunks from the Starship launch pad were approximately 90 meters per second. Intriguingly, this aligns with the predicted velocities in volcanic eruptions, where the eruption force propels materials outward. The natural analogy between these phenomena prompted Dr. Metzger and his team to explore the underlying mechanisms. To elucidate the factors at play, the researchers postulated that groundwater under the launch pad vaporized, providing the necessary mass of gas to propel the concrete at such high velocities. Their estimation, based on crater volume and the permeability of the sand beneath the pad, aligns with theoretical expectations. This leads to a fundamental concern regarding the presence of ice in lunar polar soil under a launch pad. If, as in the case of Starship, the pad cracks and allows hot gas to pass through, the vaporization of lunar ice could lead to a similar scenario, potentially resulting in even faster ejection velocities. Lunar ice is a valuable resource, often exceeding 5% in weight, making it a significant component of lunar soil. This raises the critical issue of how to prevent such scenarios in future lunar landings. Dr. Metzger and his team have proposed various solutions, including making the launch pad thicker, measuring the presence of ice before construction, and implementing vents beneath the pad. These measures aim to mitigate the risks associated with ice vaporization and the subsequent launch pad anomalies. Notably, Dr. Metzger's research has already prompted collaborative efforts with CISLUN, a forward-thinking technology lab. CISLUN is committed to accelerating humanity's return to the moon, and their involvement in projects like deflector cone and vented launch pad reflects this dedication. These projects hold immense promise in developing innovative technologies that can enhance the safety and reliability of lunar landings. CISLUN's recent achievements are a testament to their commitment to lunar exploration. They've secured 4 NASA contracts, including 2 Small Business Innovation Research, or SBIR, and 2 Small Business Technology Transfer, or STTR, awards. These contracts underscore their pivotal role in creating core technologies that not only enable lunar tourism, but also pave the way for long-term human settlement on the moon. Furthermore, CISLUN's past collaborations with NASA in 2021 and 2022 have contributed to the broader mission of returning humans to the lunar surface. The Starship launch pad anomaly, although an unforeseen occurrence, has provided a unique opportunity for scientists and engineers to delve deeper into the intricacies of lunar landings. Dr. Phil Metzger's research has not only unraveled the mysteries behind the anomaly, but has also set the stage for safer lunar missions in the future. The world will be watching with bated breath as Starship prepares for its next historic journey. And that's all for now. Thanks for watching. Please subscribe for more videos like this. Hit the like button if you find the video interesting. And kindly provide your valuable feedback in the comment section. This will help us to improve.